theme for today is He's Just a Jewel That I Have Found. Y'all know we close our service out with a song called I Love the Praise. Amen. Part of that song we sing, He's Just a Jewel That I Have Found. I want you to know all that this world has to offer us. When you found the Son, you found it all. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes the enemy will remind us of our failures. He'll remind us of those who have afflicted us, how life has dealt us a blow. But I don't care how my journey started. The fact that I found the jewel, everything else doesn't mean anything. As long as I found the jewel of Jesus on the way, I have found it all. And I think some of us need to be reminded of that, because there are times when our faith will be challenged. How many of y'all are going through a challenge like that? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's only a test.
It's only a test. Amen.
This is when God is at His best. When you got a challenge in your life. How many of you are still healing from affliction or the afflictions of yesterday? Some of us still heal from stuff years ago. But if you found the jewel, I'm telling you right now, He's licking your wounds right now. He's cleaning the wounds right now. How many know a wound can't heal until it's clean? Y'all know what I mean, right? You got to clean that thing first. Then you got to let the air blow on it a little bit, right? Then the scab starts to form, and the scab is ugly, but it's protection. Some of y'all don't like the process because it seems like your healing don't look good. Y'all ladies laughing because y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all definitely don't want to scab on your legs or your arms. Y'all don't want to know it. But a scab is necessary. It, because it protects the wound. So let the jewel that you have found do the healing. Because He is the great healer. Hallelujah. I bless Him today. In these two parables, we have a treasure and a pearl. Ooh. That's some valuable stuff going on there, right? But if you notice, they're being compared to the kingdom of heaven. Boy, when Reverend Stan sang that song, when we all get to heaven, what a great day of rejoicing that will be. I'm here to tell you right now, we can't imagine what that's going to be like. But He doesn't allow you to go there because He says we must walk by faith and not by sight. But what happens now, most of you know God's been good to you.
Yes.
If you really think, just for a couple minutes, about all those times that He brought you through, you know He's been good.
Hallelujah.
He's been good.
Yes.
As soon as a cloud shows up, we forget about all of the times that God was there. Just, I'll be honest with you, I don't even care about the blessings. I thank Him for His mercy in my life. And life was good and you just wanted to accept Jesus. That is not my story. He had to knock me down and pick me up. Y'all hear what I'm saying? And then when He knocked me down, He didn't knock me out. Aren't you glad He didn't knock you out? And then He turned around and He doesn't just knock it down. He doesn't knock you out, but He I need you, and he doesn't show up.
I don't cry. I don't complain.
Right.
I remember the day, the words of Brother David, when he said, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. I go back to what he did for me yesterday, because if he didn't, then he'll do it again. I don't know where you're at today, but he bailed you out before. Because we know that this pearl and this treasure, they will find. When we talk about finding something now, sometimes we're not looking for it. Amen.
Amen.
I wasn't looking for God when I found him. I had fallen on my face. And I looked up and I said, I need something. See, there are a lot of people falling on their face. But they're finding the wrong gods. See, when I fell, Islam was running pretty rapid in the African American community. I was being recruited by the 5%. So at the time when we fall, we're trying to find anything because we're tired of listening to us. You know, every now and then, you know, you need to get knocked down before you decide, well, maybe I shouldn't do this anymore. Maybe I should do it my way. Maybe I need some help.
Right.
Some of you young people in here, please don't fall in the same trap that we did.
Amen.
When we think we know it all.
Yeah.
Y'all don't know nothing. I'm sorry to tell you, but y'all don't know nothing. You ain't never had another bill in your name.
Yeah.
How can you tell me anything? Trust those who have journeyed.
Yes.
This road that you're journeying.
Amen, amen.
The point I'm making is that a lot of times when we fall, we're looking up and we want something or somebody to guide us. Okay? And I thank God that I was trained in his ways right here in his church. I thank God that my upbringing was the Bible. Because when I fell, when I got up, I came to this church. I didn't go to a temple somewhere. I didn't go to a place where the Mormons worship. I came to a church where Jesus Christ was proclaimed. I came to a place where the real jewel resides. A lot of people meeting today talking about a God. Our nation, when I do now funerals for folks I don't know real well, I had to identify. I just want y'all to know before we begin that I represent the Bible.
Yes.
This is what we have to do in our country now. You have to identify because we've gotten so far away from the true jewel. When the dust settles, y'all heard me say it before, the Bible will be standing all by itself. Jesus, the jewel, said it himself. Going to bow. We talk about looking for something. I can remember when I was young and you find something. Look what I found. Y'all remember that? One time I was going to Galbraith. How many of y'all for real remember that little store Galbraith? And back then a quarter could buy you a whole lot of candy. You need candy for a week.
Just going, oh my God, did I
The treasure is hidden in the field. Sister Terry read that, right? Okay. And the field represents the world and all that is in the world, right? Which causes now this treasure to be hidden.
Hallelujah.
Every day, the kingdom of God, the true jewel, it becomes harder and harder to find. Because the enemy now, of all the religions, wants to cripple the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because he knows Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. He doesn't care if you mention Buddha. He don't care if you mention Muhammad. But mention the name Jesus. And everything now goes into a frenzy. The attack is on the attack is mainly against the Church of Jesus Christ. So now we're seeing now this treasure. The field is so ripe that every day the kingdom of God is becoming harder and harder to find. But aren't you glad you found it?
Yes, yes.
Aren't you glad you can sit here and say, I know the truth, and the truth has set me free?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Now the problem now is there will come a time when he won't be found. Let me read this in Isaiah 55, verse 6 and 7. You're not concerned it, but it says, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return to the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. See, there's going to come a time when he won't be found. Hallelujah. And I'll say this to you. Some of us in the church, God has been telling you for a while now, you need to get that area up. God has been telling you, my mercy now has been there every morning for you. But after a while, my mercy ain't going to be found. Hallelujah. One thing about the Lord, he is gracious to warn us. I've been there.
Yes.
I mean, you know what I'm talking about with that warning.
Yes,
he's a blessing.
Yes.
Because he'll warn you. See, some of us, we think because so-and-so don't see us, we good. My wife didn't see me do that. Oh, you know, I used to deliver packages and the ladies would come to the door. Wait, you're not supposed to be here now. My husband's here now. Some of them would get the packages delivered to the office. Oh, I get all my stuff here. Yeah, hub in my ass. Somebody laughing out there. Hubby might not see you. Daddy and mom might not see you. The wife might not see you. But he sure sees you.
Amen.
The eyes of the Lord go to and fro throughout the earth.
Yes. To show himself strong.
Uh-huh.
Is he going to be strong in mercy, or is he going to be strong in judgment? Because judgment will show up. Matter of fact, God will let you enjoy yourself. Laying in your mud and doing what you're doing. He'll even let you do that for a few years. I mean, you know what I'm talking about. Then out of nowhere, he'll just show up. How you like me now? I don't know who this is for, but you know, there's going to come a time when his mercy won't be found. Amen?
Amen.
I don't know who that's for, but let it linger. Now, in verse 44, if you notice, the first thing the man does is he protects what he has found by hiding it. Y'all see that? It says, again, the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field, which a man, now he found the treasure, but then he turned around and he hides it again. And what that's saying to us now is, we have, Jesus said, now that the kingdom of heaven is within you. Right? Did he not say the kingdom of God is within you? So if that's in us, make sure that we protect it.
Yes.
Amen. Because we are living in some difficult days.
Yes, we are.
And you need to decide whose side you're on.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. Because the enemy is everywhere. Your neighbor could be a serial killer. You don't know what's going on. You've been seeing Bob borrowing his sprinkler. You've been borrowing his hammer and saw. Next thing you know, Bob is on the news. I'm just keeping it real. This is how bound people are. Why? I'm not going to get into it now. But in the book of Revelation, it tells us that the enemy doesn't have much time. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth, for the devil knows his time is short. So when you see all this stuff going on, we have to jewel. We don't have to get upset. We don't have to get concerned. We don't have to talk politics all day long. All you got to do is just say, Jesus is coming. Let me answer that for you. It ain't about the White House. It's about the Lighthouse. Jesus is coming back. That's all I can tell you. I don't care who get in the White House. Jesus, the trump will sound and the dead Christ will rise. Hallelujah. We give you praise, amen. Let's protect this jewel, this treasure. Let's protect it. It says that he found it and he hid it again. Why did he hide it? If I go behind Sister Terry's yard in her back yard and I find something buried, it's not mine. Because it's on Terry's property. Oh, you're not here.
He tried.
You know what I mean? And as bad as I would want it, because she lives on the river, I would have to turn around and leave and go save my money. And do all I can day and night, laboring and saving to buy her out. Because the only way I can get it is to buy the property. This is where God is telling us we need to be. Let's protect the kingdom of this. Take the time. Let's get back to reading that chapter of Psalms every day. Spending that 15 minutes with the Lord. With the door shut. Amen?
Amen.
Let's protect this treasure. Alright, y'all?
Amen.
Now, because of time, I'm gonna cut this short because I think it's always important when we can let our young people say amen for our young people again.
Amen.
It is important that our young people have their time in church.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But I want to read a very familiar story to y'all in closing. We're not going to go into the pearl. I think the Lord has spoken to us enough about through the treasure. This is the story of the man that collected portraits. I'm sorry, he collected paintings. Y'all heard the story? And his son and him passionately spent time going out buying expensive paintings. And during the Vietnam War, his son, who he loved, was called into battle. The son, while